We have a nice daytime Wednesday matchup on the way. It'll be the Los Angeles Dodgers taking on the Florida Marlins in Miami. The MLB here on 2K Sports.
Time to grab that seat. Sun Life Stadium filling up. Let's get ready for our ball game. Always great to be playing at home, and today the Florida Marlins get to do just that. Here with Steve Phillips and John Kroc, I'm Gary Thorne. This end of April MLB game. And we'll take a look at the starting pitcher for Florida. So, Steve, what's he going to be conscious of? What's he thinking about as he gets into this Dodger lineup?
There are times where this lineup can be a challenge for pitchers. But the quality stuff this right-hander has, though, if he's on top of his game today, he should be able to get the job done for his manager. Now, some kind of offense right here. Star-studded lineup and really great length and depth with guys that really can put the ball in play.
Robinson into the batter's box. It was a loss last time out for the Dodgers. That tied the three-game set at one apiece. Chance to take the series against the Marlins. That curve is just a little bit outside. One ball, no strikes. Look back at that last game for a moment. Looked like they might stage a comeback.
Yeah, they had a little rally going right there at the end, but they just fell short.
Here's the 1-0. Ooh, that looked good, but he falls behind 2-0.
Well, smart hitter realizes he's off balance. Lay off that pitch. Don't swing. Wait for the next one.
Swing and a drive. Deep left center. That one's gloved. Now we'll take a quick look at the Marlins and how they take the field on defense. And you'll want to tune in next Monday. Broadcast from Great American Ballpark, the Reds at home, as they take on the Houston Astros. All gets going at 7 p.m. Eastern.
Well, I guess, look, if you and John are going to be at that one, I want to go do that game, too, because that looks like it's going to be a good one.
Base is empty, one out.
0-1.
Here's the delivery. Starts him out with a fastball for a strike.
Now that he's established the strike zone down and in, he can elevate a pitch or go with something soft away from the hitter.
Ball. Too far inside, 1-1. There's a swing and a miss at the fastball. It's 1-2. Fastball inside. He had to do a little dancing on that one.
Well, that's an intentional pitch right there. He wants to keep the hitter from leaning out over the plate.
Two-two on the way. Two retired here.
And a brief look here at the Dodgers. Take a look at the National League rankings and where they fell in last season. Eighth in stolen bases, 10th in batting average, and they were the top 10 in hits. A lineup that was able to make a lot of contact and put the ball in play.
And we've got Snyder batting. Two outs, bases empty. Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. And that one's going to drop in. That'll be our first hit of the game.
Well, even though there's two outs, you never want to think you're out of an inning. And this guy came up there and hit this ball hard somewhere. He gets on base with that solid hit, and who knows what can happen after that.
Runner on first, two away. Boy, he scorched that one. That was right over the mound. Throws to first, side is retired. No runs at a base hit. They leave one man on at first. Bottom half coming up, Florida Marlins. Well, let's take a look at our starting pitcher for Los Angeles. Steve, what do you think the strategy is going to be against Florida today?
Well, we got a lefty on the mound in this one. Some of the best stuff in the league among the elite left-handers in the game. I guess they're a lot.
He squares around and he gets this one down. Koufax. And his throw is in time for out number one.
Got to like the creativity, trying to get on any way that you can, but just didn't locate that bunt where he needed to beat it out and be safe.
The Marlins lineup looks like this.
Okay, this is what I call a circular lineup. Stars really throughout the lineup, they're all the same. They hit for average, hit for power, drive-in runs, really star-studded throughout.
One out, bases empty. Line to left, but that's going to go foul.
Foul!
He's at 0-2. He watched that fastball that was in there.
When you can spot your four-seam fastball to the outside corner, the hitter has to have balance at the plate and not pull off the ball.
Fastball, got him looking, two down.
And he only got to see three pitches. Now, unhittable pitches, but he saw them nonetheless.
Boy, that's a tough at-bat for the hitter. He's got to walk away almost before he even got there. We'll take a quick look at the Dodgers and see what they look like defensively. Bases empty and two down.
Forward.
Fastball misses away. 1-0. One oh on the way. Fastball just misses and he falls behind 2-0. Swing and a high drive. This could be trouble. Out of here, a home run. And the first run of the ball game. Wow, it comes with a solo home run and a 1-0 lead.
A great piece of hitting right there. He turns on that one, rotates the hips, and drives the ball.
And that's going to give them the lead here and an early lead.
Now we're going to see if they can tack on a few more here in the first and put the pressure on. Marlins offense coming together right here, Gary, able to take the lead. Now they want to ride this momentum and see if they can't extend it.
Bases empty with two outs.
Strike
starts
one.
Him off with a strike down the heart of the plate. Steve, they'd love to see their bats going here. You just love to get a big jump in a ball game.
Now, you know, you have to wonder whether nerves are a factor here in the first inning and affecting the way these pitchers are going at.
Missed with a fastball outside, and it's even at one. That misses down in the zone, 2-1. The pitch.
Ball.
Fastball gets away from him there, and it's 3-1.
Well, anytime you have a count 3-1 in your favor as the hitter, you're looking for a pitch in a little box in the location you want to. If he throws it in there, you better be ready and get a good hack at it.
That one's drilled to short. And with two down, they've got a man on board.
Well, it's still early on in the new baseball season for the Florida Marlins. Let's see where they sit in the National League. First in batting average of runners in scoring position, first in strikeouts, and they're also the number one team in stolen bases. Great team speed and great instincts, that ability to read a pitcher's move and get a great jump. They get it done. Well, you've got the lead right now with speed on first base. You have to get him going, I think, Gary. Keep the pressure on. Keep trying to tack on some runs. Now he's surrendered three straight hits. He's got to bounce back and get this guy. He needs an out.
It's going to be Johnson now. Two down. Runners at first and second.
Ball one.
Can't get him to chase that one outside. Ball one.
Well, you see, he just missed with that fastball right there away. Let's see if they try to come back inside to try to jam him.
Let's go, Marlins!
Ready with a 1-0.
Ball
fastball
two.
In the dirt. Good block by the catcher. Here it comes. He looks at that fastball. Called strike. 2-1. Comes set. Here's the 2-1 pitch.
Strike two.
He watches the fastball go by. Now it's 2-2.
There's a reason they put the number one down when signaling for the fastball. It has to be your number one pitch, your best pitch. That's what he saw right there.
2-2 pitch.
Oh.
Catcher can't control it. Hit up the middle. Robinson, and he gets in there without a throw. They come out strong, putting a run on the board early. The Marlins lead 1-0. The 5-6-7 hitters coming up. Campanella at the plate. Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0.
Ball two.
Now the 1-0 pitch. That's outside, ball two.
Strike one.
He delivers. And here's a fastball for a called strike, 2-1. Here's the 2-1. Fastball on the black. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, he tried to go outside on the outside corner with that fastball right there. Just got a little bit off the plate. He's got to be careful, though. You don't want that hitter to get his arms extended.
Ball four. Potential tying run is on.
Well, that's what you want to do. You want to have quality at bats, get that pitch count up. And I tell you what, he worked this pitcher. It's going to be tough for him to get this next hitter out after working that walk on so many pitches.
And in the batter's box, it's Green. Runner on first base, nobody out. On the way. And he offers up the pound ball and misses, 0-1. He tries to frame that palm ball, but it's 1-1. The 1-1 now. That's off the plate low, and it's 2-1.
Well, you see there, he tried to go on that outside corner down and away. Give the hitter a lot of credit, though. You know that's a pitch you can't hit, so don't even swing at it. Well, and the catcher looked like he really wanted that one.
There's a ball hit deep left center field. This ball way back. Gone, a two-run homer. Great turnaround for him. A two-run homer. They lead by one. With two runs coming in to score on that long ball, we can take a look at the win expectancy graph.
Now, Gary, looked like he was setting on that pitch. He got it and drove it out of the park.
What they're going to want to do in this ball game now is take advantage of that and build that momentum up.
Well, they need to still be aggressive out there and go right after it. Well, this is what the Dodgers wanted to do. Los Angeles getting in a position now where they can build this lead.
No outs and nobody on base. Hot shot towards the hole. He stops at first. That'll be a single.
That ball was well struck. Good piece of hitting. The infield playing back. Had a little more ability to cover some ground, but he was able to get it by him.
Hodges is the batter. A runner on first, no outs.
Ball!
Just missed with the fastball, 1-0. Here's the 1-0.
Ball!
Looked like the palm ball, and it drops low, 2-0.
That palm ball down in the zone, you want it starting there and sinking out, but the hitter realizes if it starts at the bottom, it's going to be a ball. Good piece of hitting.
Here's the pitch. And he lays off that one. It's inside for ball three.
The pitcher can't find the zone right here, but I'm still giving my hitter the green light. I think he has enough discipline to get a good pitch and try to drive it.
Fastball. He's taking all the way. 3-1.
Velocity and location are absolutely critical. That pitch was exactly where he wanted to throw it.
There's a swing and a liner. And there's one. Over to first and safe. Very close play. They will not get the double play. Here's how the Eastern Division race is looking as April winds down, courtesy of State Farm. Marlins out in front, first place. It's the Mets in second. Third goes to the Phillies. In fourth place, it's the Nationals. And the Braves, they are in last place.
Florida Marlins got off to a great start this season, and certainly a bit surprising if they can sustain it, but so far, they have to feel good about themselves.
Line drive fouled off towards first. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1. Fouled off. The 1-2 on its way. That one misses. It gets away from the catcher.
Well, K-Cam registers that at 79 miles per hour with little movement, if any. Got him to chase that ball down and away. Good pitch, not real good execution by the hitter.
Two outs and a man on first. First pitch to him. Swing and a miss on that curveball. It's 0-1.
Well, that's a great location down in the strike zone with that curveball. And like the right there, you got to swing and miss. But even if they make contact, you're going to get a grounder somewhere to your infield.
Well, he's running, taking off for second. And his throw, he is out. Great throw. So they strike for two runs, and that gives them the lead. LA's got the lead now. It'll be the bottom third of the order coming to the plate. Leadoff man in the box. Lays off a called strike of the knees, 0-1.
Now that he's established the bottom of the strike zone, it gives him so many options. He can go to the breaking ball or climb the ladder with another fastball.
Here's the pitch. Big swing and a drive. Deep left center field, going back to the wall. Tell it goodbye. And they're happy to tie that one up. Back to an even ball game with that solo shot.
Well, Gary, this is the second home run they've hit off him in this game. So when he gets the ball up and makes a mistake, they hit it out.
He's got to be thinking about exactly what he threw in those cases and maybe change it up a little.
Clearly to those guys, he's going to have to do it. Well, managers like it when their teams are relentless offensively. That's what they did to tie this up. Now let's see if they can make their manager very happy and take the lead.
Empty bases, three outs to go here. Pitch on the way. Fastball in there for a called strike. Steve, this kind of home run to tie a game, you get it late, everybody's standing, you were hoping for it. You kind of hope, I guess, you're not hoping for it this early, but they got it.
Well, but they're showing they can match, you know, swing for swing what the other team's doing, so it can make a big difference.
Shallow left center, and so Wells retired. That's one down. Now a look at the standings in the Western Division as we get through the first month of the season. It's brought to you by State Farm. First place, the Dodgers. Second place, it's the D-backs. Giants in the third spot. It's the Padres in fourth. And the bottom dwellers, the Colorado Rockies. One out, nobody on. Fastball swung on a miss, 0-1.
It's tough for hitters to protect both sides of the plate. You can't protect the outside and the inside, especially when you're throwing your fastball down and away.
One and one. Fastball misses low that time, 1-1.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone, around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Swing liner back up the middle. That should be a base hit.
Well, we've got a moment to look back here at the Florida Marlins and how they fared last year. Third in triples, fourth in doubles, and they were in the top 10 in home runs. That ability to drive the ball really paid dividends for this team's offense.
And the number 7 batter in the box. Grounded out his last time through. Runner at first with one down. He deals. There's some agility to get out of the way of that pitch.
Well, that's a wake-up call right there. You think, I'm going to go up, have a nice leisurely at bat. Not so fast. Look out.
inside with the fastball, 2-0. Fastball in the dirt that time. He stays off it. Swing, sets this one pretty well. Deep right center. That's the second out of the inning. Lloyd is up now. Called out on strikes in his last appearance. Two outs and a man on first. First pitch on the way. Fastball misses away. 1-0.
Well, you see, he just missed with that fastball right there away. Let's see if they try to come back inside to try to jam him.
Ball. 1-0 is a fastball that runs away. 2-0. Here's the delivery. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. And it's starting to head out towards the wall. He's thinking extra bases. And he's going to try for it. And that will score the run. Tie broken. They've got the lead. Well, I was already to mark this down on the card as a double. Put another line in there.
Well, he didn't let up at all, Gary. Great effort on his part. Took a chance, but he made it.
Amazing thing is he was able to do it standing up. Here's Gibson now with an opportunity at the plate. And with the lead, this lineup looks as though they're ready to do some more damage. There's still a ways to go, but pitching's going to catch up here.
That was a good piece of hitting right there. He got his pitch, took advantage of it, drove it, picked up the run.
Two outs, a runner 90 feet from scoring at third. Here's the first pitch. First pitch fastball misses badly that time, 1-0. And you get a feeling, even though it's early in this ballgame, that every run in this one is going to matter.
Well, that's why they have to look to keep tacking on runs, try to sustain the lead. When you've got an opportunity like this, you need a big hit.
This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. And that's going to do it in this half inning. So they strike for two runs, and that gives them the lead. Marlins jump out ahead in this one. And our afternoon a bit overcast today. Still a good day to be at the ball yard. Here's the first pitch. It's strike one. Can't make contact on the fastball.
Well, you can tell his timing way off after seeing him swing at that four-seamer.
Ball. Here's the delivery. Takes one off the plate to even the count at one. Outside for a ball, and it's 2-1. And here's the pitch. Fastball sails high, 3-1.
Well, this is your dream when you're in the on-deck circle before you go into the batter's box. If you can get the count to 3-1 and in your favor, you know you have the upper hand.
That misses ball four, the potential tying run on base.
Pitcher tried to expand the strike zone to get the hitter to chase, but he didn't chase. Take your base.
Wheat in the box now.
Oh, Gary, that walk right there is the tying run in this game. That's not how you want to make the opposition do it. Make them earn it.
Runner on first. First pitch, and he lays one down here. Number 13, and he throws on to first for the out, one away.
Gary, you know what? He didn't beat it out at first base, but he sacrificed himself to get the runner in scoring position.
Sometimes those things get lost in the course of a game, but not for the guys on the field. They realize the importance, especially if they get the run here.
You know, we always celebrate the guy who drives in the run, but he's in scoring position because his teammate got a bunt down.
And on second, one away. Here's the first pitch.
Foul.
This one's grounded near third. Foul. Pitch on the way.
Strike.
Looks
two.
At a fastball in there, and it's quickly 0-2.
Well, the hitter lays off this pitch, realizing you can't do much. When you get that kind of four-seam fastball down and away, it's tough to hit.
Here's the pitch. Fastball in there. Struck him out. Out number two.
Good velocity on that. You can get away with making some mistakes at that kind of number.
Well, couldn't pull the trigger. He couldn't even get it started.
He came right back with another fastball, John.
Well, you see him go fastball, fastball like that, and you know he has a lot of confidence in that heater right now.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. The first pitch.
Ball.
Fastball just misses. 1-0.
Well, you can see what he's doing. He's just pulling that ball away from him, trying to overthrow it, and he can't seem to find the strike zone. He has to be able to rein that thing in right now.
The 1-0 now.
Ball two.
Misses outside for ball two. He's ready. Now the 2-0. Swung on. That is hit. It is through, and the go-ahead runs on board. He's around third, heading for the plate. And he comes home. That's it. We are tied.
The infield played it deep like they knew he was going to swing away. He did, but was still able to find a hole.
Campanella up now. This club knew it had to match some production here, and they've done it.
Gary, that was a great piece of hitting right there. It allowed them to pull it even here early in the game. Nice response.
Runner on first, two away.
Ball.
Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0. And you get a feeling early on, this ball game is up for grabs. This could be anybody's.
Well, it's certainly going to be a battle. I don't think there's any question about that. You have to keep it close, especially with this guy on the mound. That's why this at-bat is critical.
Picked up by Johnson.
He's out.
Throws on to first. Side is retired. So they score a run, one hit, and leave a man on. And it'll be the Marlins coming right up. Cleanup batter, due up next. Number three slot up again here. He's one for one so far. And the first pitch. It's now 0-1. Watch that fastball go by.
Sometimes you get a pitch, and if it's early enough in the count, you can just say, not this one, I'm going to wait for the next one.
Missed with the fastball outside, and it's even at one.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch, just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
And that one is swung on and hit. It'll be Snyder. One away. Here's a look at what's coming up for the Dodgers. Today is the last game of this Florida series. They'll get on the road tomorrow. Then they'll have home field advantage as they take on the Padres and the bat of Adrian Gonzalez. That's a team they handled all right the last time up. They'll try for a repeat performance. That's a three-game series. Then they stay home for the next series. The Chicago Cubs. Home sweet home for a while here. They'll try to make the most of it. Number two spot in the lineup up again. Had a base hit his last time up. Base is empty with one away. Here's the pitch. Lays off a called strike, 0-1.
Well, that's a quality fastball right there. Just pounding the strike zone down and away. He had no chance to put that one in play.
Here's the pitch. Smash towards the hole. And he pulls into first base with that base hit. There's one down here.
Well, he waited for that one to get deep in the zone, and he put a good swing on it. Now, with one out, let's see if they try to move him along.
It's going to be Johnson now. Grounded out last time. One down, runner at first. And here's the first one. First pitch, fastball, 0-1.
Well, when you throw the fastball, that's where you want it to go. Now you can elevate a pitch next time around.
On the way. Watches that one for a called strike. Nothing and two.
This is the go-to pitch for many pitchers in the major league. The fastball down and away. When in doubt, that's where you go.
Fastball is a waste pitch that time, 1-2. Catcher can't control it, gets away from him, so they can't make the play.
Well, listen, it's all about advancing base runners in the game. You got to make plays defensively, but that error cost him, and it came out of his hand wrong, and the ball sailed on him.
Swings and grounds this one to the right side. Foul. Ball. Outside for a ball, and it's full, 3-2.
Well, you see, he just missed with that fastball right there away. Let's see if they try to come back inside to try to jam him.
The full count pitch. Hit up the middle. Robinson. And he's in there. No play. That one took a tricky hop. Up again now, the number five spot. He homered back in inning number two. At first and third, one away. There he goes towards second.
Ball!
And they're going to have to eat this one. He is in standing up. Liner towards the hole. One. But he'll hang on to that, so they will get one.
Well, he keeps the runners right where they are, so now he's just an out away from working his way out of danger and keeping this game tied.
Runners at second and third with two outs. Here's the first pitch. Fastball runs inside, 1-0.
Well, that pitch just took off right there and exploded out of the pitcher's hand. Kept it just a little bit inside, though. Tough pitch to hit. Good job by the hitter to lay off.
Down and away for ball two. Comes set, now the 2-0. Swings and hits this one deep down the line and left. that's out number three. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. Dodgers 3, Florida 3. For those of you just joining in, I'm Gary Thorne along with John Kruk and Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Takes a swing at that fastball, can't connect, 0-1.
Well, you can tell by that approach, he was looking for that fastball. He got it, but still out in front.
Here it comes. Started to go around, held up, but it's in there, 0-1. Looked like a palm ball, swung on and missed, first out.
Here's the palm ball coming at you in K-Cam to get a better look. Well, he climbs the ladder on him, Gary, and he just didn't have enough bat speed to catch up to that pitch.
Base is empty, one out. First pitch to him. Swing and a liner to right center. Gets down. The go-ahead runs on base. Here's what's next for the Marlins. This is their final game with the Dodgers. Schedules open tomorrow. They hit the road for what should be a competitive series. The Reds at Great American Ballpark. That'll be a three-game series. Then they'll continue on with another road series. The Cardinals at Busch Stadium. A lot of road games on the way. Hodges batting now. 0-for-1 thus far. One out, runner on at first. He delivers. Swing and a line drive. That's one out. And he's going to hang on to it. No relay, so they will not get the double play. It's Reese at the plate. A runner on first with two outs. And the first pitch.
Ball.
Just missed with the fastball, 1-0. Pauses, and now the 1-0. Swung on, grounded towards the hole. And they get him at first base. Good hustle by the pitcher to get over there.
Now, great work by the pitcher there. He's normally not called upon to play first base. He does a nice job completing the task and getting the out.
No runs on a hit, and they'll strand him. We're still tied here in Florida. Bottom part of the order will get their chance offensively. Leonard in the box. Single and scored his last time around. The pitch. Watches that fastball. That goes by him for a strike. Here's the pitch. Swings, and there's a drive. Very deep, high, right center field. Goodbye, home run. And a solo home run. They lead by a one.
Well, the pitcher's going to have to make some adjustments right now, Gary. That's the third home run he's given up in this game.
The hitters have figured out some kind of sequence they're cueing on.
Now, good hitting coaches help the hitters do that. Marlins offense coming together right here, Gary. Able to take the lead. Now they want to ride this momentum and see if they can't extend it. continues to go well here for the Marlins. Good hitting.
Nobody on base and nobody out. First pitch on the way. Fastball is downstairs. One ball, no strikes.
Well, that fastball right there just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
1-0 pitch. Fastball low, 2-0. Fastball called strike 2-1.
Well, that's a hitter's pitch right there. Fastball right down the heart of the plate. He didn't swing. Swing the bat. Come on.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. Fastball on the black. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, even though you're 3-1 in the count, you still have to be patient at the plate. Make him throw a quality pitch. If he does, be ready for it. And if you're the pitcher, you better not throw anything down the middle and hope he's taking it, because he can take you out of the yard.
He went with a fastball in a 3-ball count, which is what you want to do most often. He just couldn't throw a strike.
Lloyd gets a turn here. Last time up, triple homer run. No one out and a runner on first. First pitch, right down Main Street for a strike on one.
Well, that's right down the chute. The hitter must have been looking for something else. Otherwise, you have to swing at that.
Waves at that fastball in the hole now, 0-2.
Well, that's some kind of pitching. You set up the target on the outside corner, and he paints the black with it. Awfully tough when you have that kind of location.
Big swing and a miss on a heater. Strike him out, one down.
Well, two strikes, you have to try to fight off this pitch. You have to think away and adjust in. They went away, but he couldn't make contact.
Here's Gibson now with an opportunity at the plate. Big things can happen anytime he steps in that batter's box. Runner at first with one down. The pitch. Fastball misses away. 1-0. He watches this one right down the middle, 1-1.
Well, the pitcher gets away with one right here. Fastball right down the heart of the plate. Batter just let it go by.
Now the 1-1. Swings and sends it deep into right field. This ball way back. And bye-bye, that's a 2-run homer. A little distance now, increasing their lead 1-3. The home run coming with a runner on. Now two RBIs on one swing. Let's see how the WPA graph looks after that one.
That's the second time today he got his pitch and absolutely drove it out of the park.
This could be a home run day. It looks as though they're able to lift that ball in their at-bats.
They're just so locked in. Seeing the ball, it looks like a beach ball. Continues to go well here for the Marlins. Good hitting.
Nobody on base, one away. Now the first pitch. That one swung on its line, and he can't get to it.
Well, this is a guy right here that was made to hit fastballs, and that's what he looks for, and that's what he got right there. Put a good swing on it. He knew what to do with it for that double.
One out, a runner on at second base. First pitch on the way. Big swing on this one. Sends a long, high drive, deep to right field. And he drops back to the runner on his way to third. And on that play, they'll get that runner over to third base.
Listen, they got a pitch at the waist, something he could drive. He didn't get all of it, but at least able to advance the runner.
Man on third, two outs. The pitch. Oh, my. That one came inside and plucked him.
Now, sometimes that fastball just runs in on you and you can't get out of the way. He couldn't get out of the way there.
Six slide up at the plate again.
And with that hit by pitch we saw there, Gary, now two runners on base. And it's got to be in his mind a little bit right now that he's got to be careful, but he can't be afraid to pitch inside.
Runners at first and third with two away. Here's the first pitch. Starts him out with a fastball for a strike. And Steve, after hitting that batter, what he's done as a pitcher is really set up an entirely different inning here.
Well, that's right. It's a real opportunity for the hitter because he knows that maybe the pitcher won't come inside worried about hitting him. Look for something away and drive it.
That's in there. Should score the runner. Boy, this lineup, they are hot right now. The chances, they are productive.
I tried to go down with that 0-1 pitch, but it gets blasted right back for the base hit.
And by the way he went after that in the box, Steve, it looked like he might have been guessing down there.
Well, I'll tell you what, you have to make contact behind in the count. He got a pitch over the heart of the plate. He took advantage of it.
Two men on and two men out. And Wells settles in. First pitch. Flied to right. And the sides retired as they head into the dugout. But not before they tally four times thanks to two home runs in the inning. Marlins jump out ahead in this one. We've got the top of the order coming up. Robinson into the batter's box.
Ball
on the way. Fastball just misses. 1-0.
Well, he tried to go outside on the outside corner with that fastball right there. Just got a little bit off the plate. He's got to be careful, though. You don't want that hitter to get his arms extended.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind 2-0. Now the 2-0 pitch. Line drive. That's foul towards first. Strike 2-1 delivery of fastball. Taken for a call. Strike two.
Unless you stay back and really think about going the other way, you've got no chance of hitting that four-seamer down and away.
Fastball swung out and missed. Struck him out. One away.
Well, K-Camp's going to show us the four-seam fastball here.
Well, he just looked overpowered on those two fastballs.
John thought the timing that time just didn't seem to be there in the at-bat.
Well, and a strikeout like that will give the pitcher a lot of confidence.
One out, nobody on. And here's the first one. Swung on, hit in the air to right center. The catch is made, and that's out number two.
Well, the National League has some tough teams, certainly, and here's where the Dodgers sit right now. First in walks, second in ERA. and they're ranked third in strikeouts with a pitching staff that has power stuff that works ahead of the count and hits their spots, getting a lot of swings and misses.
Two outs and nobody on.
Strike one!
Pitch on the way. First pitch, a fastball. That's in there for a strike.
Outstanding mechanics right there. He gets all of his body into the pitch. Great velocity on it. A strike away.
That's the palm ball, but it misses. One and one.
That palm ball down in the zone. You want it starting there and sinking out, but the hitter realizes if it starts at the bottom, it's going to be a ball. Good piece of hitting.
Swung on, line to right field. And in there, he's two for three today.
Well, this guy's got a lot of speed over there at first base, and it's not going to be surprised to see him off and running to try to steal this base.
Cleanup man in the box again. Singled home a run in his last at bat. Two outs and a man on first. Here's the delivery. First pitch, fastball, 0-1.
Hitters have to have great balance and be prepared for the pitch away. If you open up even a little bit, you can't catch up to that four-seam fastball on the outside corner.
Got him swinging with that curve. One ball, two strikes.
Perfect pitch right there. I mean, I don't care how long a bat you have, you're not going to get that one. Breaks out of the strike zone away, and he can't catch up.
Ball.
Tries to ring him up with a fastball away, but it's 1-2. Fastball, that's well off the plate, 2-2.
All
tough
three.
Pitch to lay off that time, full count, 3-2.
Well, any hitting coach will tell you, you can't hit that good high fastball, especially if it's out of the strike zone. It's a pitch you have to lay off of, make him bring it down to give yourself a chance.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. That's fouled back behind the plate. No throw. He goes in standing up. And another foul ball.
Well, the pitcher might just say, you know what, I'm going to throw it down the middle and hope you put it in play and hit it at someone because I can't strike you out. The seventh pitch of this at bat just gets enough of it to stay alive. Well, you just saw a great deal of plate discipline right there on the hitter. Maybe a little fatigue on the pitcher's part. They're not used to throwing that many pitches in one at bat, but the hitter wins it and gets that base on balls.
Campanella is the batter. Ground out victim last time through. Two down, runners at first and second. And the first pitch,
ball.
Too far outside, 1-0. At the belt, the 1-0.
Ball.
This
two.
Is the inside corner that time, 2-0. Here's the 2-0 pitch. There's a swing and a drive deep to left field. That one's grabbed. Side retired. They pick up no runs on a hit, and they lead 2-1. The Marlins still lead. Leonard is up now. Last time up, he launched one out of the park. First pitch on the way.
Ball one.
Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0.
Right.
1-0 delivery is a fastball in there, 1-1. Fastball gets away from him there, 2-1. Here's the delivery. That one swung on, hit in the air to deep right center field. And he's able to track it down. Number 9 spot at the plate again. Last time he walked and then came around to score. One out, bases empty. Here's the first pitch. Swing, hot shot.
What a tremendous catch right there. I mean, what a great effort getting to that ball, making that catch.
Lloyd up now. He was a strikeout victim last time through the lineup. Two outs, bases empty. Here's the first pitch. He sends this one in the air towards center. And that's going to do it in this half inning. And nothing across here in this half of the inning. Marlins 7, the Dodgers 3. Due up 6-7-8 in the lineup. And in the batter's box, it's Green. Got a couple of RBIs thus far.
Couple of productive at-bats so far in this one, despite the fact they're losing. The base hit, driving in run carry, then the home run as well. So he has swung the bat and done some damage.
0-1 the count now as we're in the sixth. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1.
Well, you see, he just missed with that fastball right there away. Let's see if they try to come back inside to try to jam him.
That's a foul ball.
Foul!
The pitch. Tried to get him to chase the fastball away, 2-2. Gave him a fastball that time, but it's outside, 3-2.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch, just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
Foul ball!
That one goes foul.
You're
big
out.
Swing and a miss on a heater. Strike him out, one down.
So he had a swing at it. Two strikes, ball up and away. A good pitch to at least put in play or foul off, but couldn't quite catch up to it.
Say at the plate. He singled his last trip. One out, nobody on. And here's the first one. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. Here's the 1-0. Contact. That one high in the air, but that's going to be foul down the right side. Missed with the fastball outside, 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Line towards second. Number six.
He's out.
And that's in plenty of time for the out. Hodges has a turn in the box. Lined out last time up. Two outs and nobody on. Here's the pitch. Fastball too low. 1-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Ball fastball. Two. Whoa. There's a wake-up call.
Well, he knew exactly what he was doing, throwing it that far in on the plate, backing the hitter off. Now he's set up to go away again.
Swing and a drive, deep into left field, racing back, warning track, wall, on it comes off the wall.
Hey, look, you'd love to see him hit a double earlier in the inning when there's no outs or even one out, but you're going to take anything you can get with two outs. Let's see if they can get another two-out hit to drive him in.
It's Reese at the plate, 0 for 2 thus far. Two outs and a runner on second. And here's the first one. Takes that first pitch low in the strike zone. Strike one.
Some guys really like the low fastball. In this situation, though, he ends up taking the pitch.
Here's the pitch. Called strike on a fastball, and it's 0-2.
Good pitchers change the hitter eye level. You go down low, then you run the fastball up high. A lot of times they just look at it go by.
Here's the pitch. Can't get him to chase the fastball. Low, 1-2. Fastball called. Strike three and the side is retired. They pick up no runs on one hit and leave a man at second. And it'll be the Marlins coming right up. Here's Gibson now with an opportunity at the plate. He's going to lead off bottom half of the sixth inning. The first pitch. First pitch way out of the zone. Ball one. Is a fastball that runs away, 2-0. Here's the 2-0. In there for a strike, 2-1. The pitch. Liner between first and second. And he puts that one away. One down. Now their rookie center fielder. He doubled and scored in his last trip to the plate. Nobody on base. One away. And the first pitch. The 0-0 delivery, a fastball taken for a strike. He delivers. Doesn't get the call on the slider. 1-1. Swing and a high drive to straightaway left field for the wall. Gone, a home run. Add one more to that lead. Solo, big fly ball up by five.
Well, Gary, when you throw one right over the heart of the plate, right down the middle, you have to expect something bad to happen.
These guys are not going to miss mistake pitches like that one.
Fortunately, nobody on base. Continues to go well here for the Marlins. Good hitting.
Base is empty with one away. First pitch, here it comes. Slider just misses, 1-0. Steve, this has been an unbelievable offensive show, and contributing to it, the long ball.
Well, you're right. I mean, every single time the pitcher made a mistake, it's been getting knocked around the ballpark.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind, 2-0.
Well, he tried to go outside on the outside corner with that fastball right there. Just got a little bit off the plate. He's got to be careful, though. You don't want that hitter to get his arms extended.
Trying to get down the bunt right there, but he missed it for a strike. One pitch. Hit hard on the ground to short. On to first, two away. It's going to be Johnson now. Hit by a pitch his last time up. He wants to get some hacks in here. Base is empty and two down. Here it comes.
Ball.
That one's going to be outside. Ball one. Ball. Inside with a fastball, 2-0. Swung on and ripped towards second. And the sides retired as they head into the dugout. So they pick up a run on the home run and add to their lead. Marlins up five. Robinson into the batter's box. 0 for 2 thus far. Now the first pitch.
Ball.
Fastball taken high, 1-0.
Well, Gary, with this big a lead here in the seventh inning, it's incumbent upon the pitcher to throw strikes, get outs right now.
Here's the 1-0. Swings and misses at the fastball. That'll even the count at one.
That fastball up and in is one of the toughest pitches to hit, because most hitters have a hole right there. You just can't get the bat head to the ball.
1-1 pitch.
Good-looking
fastball. Called the ball, though, 2-1.
Well, you see, he just missed with that fastball right there away. Let's see if they try to come back inside to try to jam him.
Here's the pitch. Lays off the fastball low for ball three.
Well, you've got to be careful right here. Look, you're down in the count 3-1. You just can't throw something in there and hope he gets himself out. This guy's too dangerous for that.
3-1, a fastball that's buying, 3-2. Now the 3-2 pitch. There's a bullet towards third. And Johnson makes the catch. Wheat up at the plate. Last time up, flew out. Base is empty, one out. First pitch. Swung on, hit sharply to first. And he steps on first. That's the second out. And we've got Snyder batting. Two for three thus far. Base is empty with two outs. And the first pitch. It's 0-1 as he swings and misses at that fastball.
Well, it's getting late right now. Two outs here in the seventh inning, and, you know, they're down by a bunch of runs. They need to start to get something going right here, Gary.
He deals. A swing line to left center. And it gets down. A 3-for-4 game. Good hitting job.
Well, he's having himself a day right here in this one. Two out hit right there. That's his third hit of the game so far.
Runner on first, two away. First pitch to him. Fastball swung out and missed, 0-1. Here's the pitch. Hit in the air to left center. That one's grabbed. Side retired. No runs and a base hit. They leave one man on at first. The Marlins still out in front. Latter third of the lineup coming up. And the number eight spot rolls around. He homered back in inning number two. Here's the first pitch. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Well, the hitter's got to regret that one. He missed his pitch right down the heart of the plate. Four-seam fastball. That hurts.
The pitch.
Ball.
Here's a slider that misses. 1-1. Swing and a miss on the slider. 1-2.
Foul!
And it's fouled off. And that's another foul ball.
Well, a 1-2 count that pitch on the outside part of the plate. Borderline pitch, you still don't know if it's going to be a ball or a strike. The last thing you want to do is take that pitch for a called strike three.
He swings and nails a liner. The catch is made. It's going to be Wells. He flew out his last time up. Base is empty with one away. First pitch on the way.
Ball.
Fastball misses away. 1-0.
Well, you're running out of time in this one. You need to give your offense some chance to try to come back in this game. They've got a lot of room to make up. If they're standing out in the field, it's not going to help.
The pitch. 1-0 pitch, a slider in there. 1-1.
He has great bite on this slider, throwing it down and into the hitter. Gets away with one, and he gets in for the strike.
1-1 on the way. Check swing, but it's in there. 1-1. The 1-2 pitch. Holds off on the slider. 2-2.
We have to remember these middle relievers. They're not used to coming in and throwing over 45 pitches, but that's where he's at right now. You might see his control run away from him a little bit right here.
And that misses below the knees. That'll run us to the full 3-2 count.
Now, if you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
And that one gets popped way up behind the plate. Out number two. Leonard settling in. Drove in a run earlier in the game. Leonard in the box now. Had a home run back in the fourth inning. Base is empty and two down. And the first pitch. First pitch fastball. Misses badly that time. 1-0.
Well, how about a chance to get through an inning without any base runners and without any runs? I mean, they've been blowing out in this one so far. Put a zero up there, and let's see if the offense can get it done.
That misses up and away. Ball two.
Well, you watch how the hitter reacted to that. He had thoughts about chasing that pitch, but at the last second decided to lay off of it.
Big swing and a miss as his eyes lit up on that pitch, but a 2-1 count.
Well, it clearly fooled him right there. He had him thinking fastball, and he pulled the string on it, got him to swing right through it.
Here he comes, 2-1 pitch. Here's a swing and a miss at the heater, and we're even at two. Tough pitch to lay off that time. Full count, 3-2.
Well, he tried to go outside on the outside corner with that fastball right there. Just got a little bit off the plate. He's got to be careful, though. You don't want that hitter to get his arms extended.
Change up, swung on and missed. That will retire the side. And they're held in check here in this half inning. Florida, 8. The Dodgers, 3. Campanella at the plate now. He's going to lead off here as we go to the eighth. Here it comes. Just missed with a fastball. 1-0.
Well, it's getting late right now. They're down a bunch, so they need a big inning here. They can't wait till the ninth to try to come all the way back. They need to try to do something now.
Now the 1-0 pitch. Hit sharply towards the hole. And out number one as he steps on the base. And in the batter's box, it's Green. Struck out swinging his last time up. One out, nobody on. Now the first pitch. And he holds off with the pitch low, 1-0.
Look, Gary, with one out right here, they still have time in this inning to try to generate some runs. They need to score here in this eighth inning and not leave it all to the ninth.
Ball 1-0 is a fastball that runs away, 2-0. And he takes a fastball for a strike, 2-1.
Well, that's a solid pitch going up in the zone with that four-seam fastball. You establish different parts of the zone, and you change the hitter eye level. In this situation, He took the pitch.
2-1 pitch, a fastball outside, 3-1.
Well, anytime you have a count 3-1 in your favor as the hitter, you're looking for a pitch in a little box in the location you want to. If he throws it in there, you better be ready and get a good hack at it.
3-2. Can't lay off that pitch. It was inside. Full count now, 3-2.
Some guys throw in, some guys pitch in. He pitched in right there to get the strike. Now let's see if he pitches away.
Popped up, should be playable behind the plate. Two away. Say at the plate. 2-for-3 thus far. Two outs, bases empty. First pitch, here it comes. Fastball is downstairs. One ball, no strikes.
Gary, I think right now that you've got to consider trading outs for runs if you're pitching. I mean, listen, just keep getting outs right now. The countdown's there. You only need 4 outs left to win this ball game.
Third hit of the game in this one. They just can't seem to find an answer for him.
And a man on first. And the first pitch. Swings, and there's a drive. High in the air. Over the wall. A 2-run home run. Now with that 2-run homer, they extend that lead to 7.
That's his second home run of the day right there. He's locked in, Gary.
That means he's seeing the baseball, Steve. Up now, their second baseman. Out, space is empty. First pitch.
Ball.
Slider misses badly with it. 1-0. And Steve, this is the point in the ball game where you are really putting it to the opposition. The long ball can do that to you late.
Well, there's no question. I mean, you give up those home runs and it just deflates your own team. So, offense ruling the day.
The 2-0 pitch, a smash towards the hole. That's caught. Side is retired. Now they add a couple more runs here and extend their lead even further. The Marlins still up big. Another chance for the leadoff hitter coming up in the inning. Hodges at the plate. He doubled in his last appearance.
Well, this is a good move right here. You're bringing in the better defensive player for the guy who could be a little suspect in the outfield. Defense helps you win games.
That's one away.
Well, obviously, winning big right now, you just want to go out there, make plays, throw strikes, force them to try to put multiple hits together to get back into this game.
It's Reese at the plate. Took a called third strike in his last time up. One out, bases empty. The first pitch.
Ball.
Fastball just misses, 1-0.
Well, anytime one of your middle relievers throws over 45 pitches, you got to wonder how much more he has left. Might want to get someone else up out there.
Here's the delivery. Second pitch waves at a fastball, strike one.
He says, I'm going to go at him, but I'm going to go at him away so that I can't get hurt. He just runs that fastball by him.
Here's the 1-1. Waves at a fastball on that 1-1 pitch. Strike two. One-two pitch coming. Swing and a miss on the fastball, second out in the inning.
You've got to have better plate discipline than that. With two strikes, you need to be defensive and try to make contact, but when you get a fastball, you need to read whether it's a strike or not.
Robinson into the batter's box. He'll be seeking his first hit of the game. Not a lot of luck so far. Base is empty with two outs. And the first pitch.
Ball!
And he watches ball two.
Well, he tried that four-seam fastball up in the zone to get him the chase. Tough pitch to lay off of. Good job by the hitter.
Now the 2-0 pitch. Swing and a fly ball, then this might be it. And you just saw it, folks. That's going to be the last play of this game.
Overpowering performance, Gary, by the Florida Marlins today, and a big win for them.
And it's that time in our broadcast where we bestow upon some lucky winner, the player of the game honors.
Well, anytime you hit a home run in a game, it's a big deal. But when you hit two home runs to help your team to a victory, that is one of the best days you can ever have. And a performance like this feels really good.
Steve, it seemed like they knew from the get-go they had it. This was going to be their day, and they were right.
You and I like the close games just because there's a little more intrigue for all nine innings, but the hometown fans, they like the offensive explosion and the big win.
So glad you could join us. For Steve Phillips and John Kruk, I'm Gary Thorne. We'll see you real soon.